had a screen for days or even weeks. The male calf is seen as useless to dairy farmers because they won't produce milk, so they're sold to be killed for veal or a cheap dairy beef, as it's called. So if they're killed for cheap dairy beef, they're killed when they're only 1 to 2 years old. And if they're raised for veal, they're kept in small, confined corridors that prevent muscle development that would decrease the value of their flesh. They're usually fed a diet that produces anemia, and they're killed within just 3 weeks or even days old, but that's by 5 months. Thank you.
see if I can get the babies to come out.
Say, I live in Charlottesville.
So let me tell you her story, and then I'll go get the babies.
The babies aren't here.
Baby pig! Oh, wait, now I don't have to go get them. I see one right now. Hello. Baby pig! Come!
Not you, Mia. You can come too.
Baby! Come on!
Hello, Mia. So pigs do not like to be dirty, and everybody thinks that they're going to be sweat. So it's like being candy coated. So it's going to
come on!
That's one of five.
What are you doing? Where are your siblings?
Where are your siblings?
Hi, what are you doing?
That's so cute.
Where did come here?
That's the run. That's the run. Come on! That's a giant. That's one of my older pigs. That's a 14-year-old right there. She's been playing in the barn.
Come on!
She can't go in the main barn. Okay, so when you have a mother pig, I want to explain this thing. So we got her in January, and she was called to this place where it was in these cases of pigs, and they were living in a garage and in a shed, and it was a disastrous nightmare. And this is the same place that we moved with pigs in 2003, and we moved 125 of them. And some of them were frozen to the ground and still alive, and we had to put them down on the site. So the place was terrible. So we didn't assume that he was going to get to do that again. He did. And so we got there, and the night before we were born, the SPCA called and said there's one mother pig that just had 17 babies. And so I was like, great. So we went in. You could not breathe when you walked in. There was light in this barn. It was like my glasses fogged up. It was the most disgusting smell I'd ever smelled. And you couldn't see. So we had to have and the figure of the guy was on. And a guy who had just been arrested and he just got caught. So, so we got in there though, and it was basically a garage had 50 pigs in it. And he had built things around the pigs instead of like, they weren't tents. He just put pallets up and like jammed in like poles and stuff in the ground and like kept them in that way. They only were fed every 3 days. We didn't have enough money to take care of them. She was not producing enough, so when we got there, and so she was so distraught, and she wouldn't let us in as a baby in the corner, so I had to like shimmy across the trusses of the garage to reach down and get her babies while she tried to kill them the whole time. We were really close at first. So I got the babies out, but one of them had a bone in his leg, and he ended up having, he died at Cornell. And she ripped the doors off of the hospital every time I tried to save babies. She ripped doors off of everything. Oh, she didn't want anybody to touch that. Yeah, and she was terrifying. She would have people against the wall, like at the stomach with her mouth wide open. We just would, don't bite me. And she would just warn us. And it was good warning. We had to keep moving her because she kept destroying everything. And now she's happy. So she's very happy now. And she has all her babies who are going to come to them, and I'll get them.
Well, part of the problem is that you have a group of people that grew up stuck,
and they don't know how to do anything else. And we haven't given them other options, and there's giant farms are coming. Because pigs aren't raised in farms. They're raised in big land. So these giant, they can't compete. They cannot compete. So they never make money, but they always keep trying. And so it's one of the saddest things, because I would prefer to like figure out how, because I actually think it would be a really good thing to have options. But like all the dairy, want to tackle that one. It's like that money.
Come on.
I'm vegan. I've been vegan for 25 years. Yeah. I haven't eaten eggs, fish, cheese, milk, nothing.
A very long time.
It's not at all. It used to be hard to find things to eat. It used to be impossible.
Does she like to get that?
I don't trust her 100%.
Trying. Kyle, I need to get a picture of you with one.
Scratch that one's belly. That's the run. That's Woody. Woody's like, I'm the cutest, and I also like to have my belly. The girls are like, I hate Woody. He gets all the attention. He is the sweetest pig I know.
Stay in this pasture? Or
yeah. Oh, yeah. They love this pasture. We're probably going to cut and give them more, though, as they get older.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I know, but I was saying
this pasture won't need to stay.
How much would it cost to get it all cleaned up?
Oh, they did this. It was last week or last month, it had like big like chamomile everywhere, so it looked like a field of daisies. It will get more grass in.
Oh.
They eat it all. The problem is them, actually.
Yeah.
And pigs can root up, I think, a couple acres in a day, so
they
can roll it. Yeah. Everything, yeah. You have to start over every year. And the only thing that grows, I know, and the only thing that really grows is things that they don't like milkweed. Grows really well here. Yeah. Milkweed and chamomile. Yeah. They hate milkweed and they hate chamomile.
Oh, here comes another one.
She said, don't pet the mom.
Yeah, just watch the mom.
All right.
I love her to death. She's done great. She used to pen us against the wall. So we're good now. She's like, those are my babies. She's watching everybody. They were born, and they're actually older. They were born in January. Yeah. Yeah, and we restrict their diet because we don't want them to get too big too quick.
How much does she weigh?
She's still small. I'd say she probably weighs... wait till you see that full grown thing. I don't think she's full grown. So, she was a young mom, so I'd say she probably weighs...
500, 450.
Yeah, some of the boys weigh 900. So, and that's on a very restricted diet.
Do they cut her tails?
They dock the tails because when they like warehouse raise them or tightly raise them, they bite their tails. A lot of undercover stuff with